When India's healthcare system was decimated by increasing COVID infections, Prerna and her friends from Miranda House stepped up to help those in need. They made a website under COVID Aid India to provide verified leads pertaining to oxygen and other life-saving medicines. Prerna addressed over 100 SOS calls an hour and worked round the clock to help people in need. NewsX proudly recognizes second wave superhero Prerna Sinha and her team. Joining me today is one such student who has been helping out people amidst all this chaos. Prerna Sinha, she's a final year philosophy student from Miranda House, Delhi University. Thank you so much, Prerna, for joining us today.
Thank you, Deeksha. Well, thank you.
Okay. Well, let me begin with asking, you know, about the Miranda Desk COVID helpline, which you have been part of, where you were volunteering. What exactly is it? And, you know, tell us about it.
Okay, so if I tell you my personal experience and how things started, so basically, very much around the COVID situation worsened in Delhi. There were people who were asking for information, any sort of information that they have regarding hospital admissions, availability of oxygen. Now, as a student and as a person, actually, I've never heard of a thing. I've never come across shortage of oxygen. Like, these are certain kind of things that you're supposed to, like, you're mentally prepared for people to run out of beds or injections, but oxygen, so we've always had this in mind that oxygen is something that the hospital is automatically going to provide you with, but then people started running short of it. And there were leads, there were huge messages of information, there were a lot of links which were being forwarded all over social media. Our class groups were flooded with them. Some people were posting stories regarding how they need certain resources, and the other people were posting stories regarding how can they provide certain resources. But then what happened, there's a huge gap in between a person who's asking for the resource and the supplier, and that gap had to be bridged. Now the problem here is that anybody who is in a situation of crisis, for example, the patient's family, friends, whoever are in charge of the situation, you cannot expect them to go ahead and verify each and every contact that's been passed on to them. And because they are already in a situation where they can't afford to lose time, or they don't even have the mental capacity to do it after a certain point, because this is something that I realized after one single day, that it takes a mental toll on you. So one of my classmates, who is also my batchmate, we're in the same department, she came up with this idea that let's do something, because all of us have been working on a personal level. What if we, like, accumulate all our efforts, come up as a team, and then, you know, we divide sections, we divide departments, and we start looking into particular resources and put them in certain columns. So that is how we came up with the whole idea of MH Helpdesk. And it's the name has MH because it was initially started by the students of Miranda, but then other people also joined in, and it's been teamwork, I would say, and no certain person or a certain group of people, even the people who started it, they cannot be completely credited with the kind of things that we are.
Prerna, tell us about, you know, what tall challenges did you face when you were working for the, you know, Gwalior volunteership? You know, what all challenges did you face? Because Delhi, we know. Tell us about what exactly was happening in Gwalior.
So I think my experience about Delhi and Gwalior, they're both very interconnected. And okay, Miranda helpline, like the MH help desk, was working specifically for Delhi NCR for a certain period of time, although we are trying to, because we are getting leads from all over the country. So we are trying to verify as much as possible, but then the spreadsheet that we are creating, which is there in the bio and which I must have sent you as well, that spreadsheet contains information that will apply only at the Delhi NCR level. And we were receiving calls from all around Delhi, and like within a span of 15 minutes, I would receive around 100 phone calls. And the sad part about receiving phone calls, when every phone call, every query sort of phone call that I used to attend, it used to be around a minute, because I had to explain them the next procedure that they're supposed to shift to, contacting the suppliers who are verified buyers, etc. So during one single conversation, I used to miss around 4 or 5 calls. So the situation was very bad. And then this is one thing that I realized, because I'm not a store, like I do not belong to Delhi. I'm not a resident of Delhi NCR. So I used to feel guilty regarding the fact that I have information regarding Delhi. I'm constantly posting about Delhi, but I don't know anything about Gwalior. And in that moment, it used to make us feel guilty, like all the outstation students especially. So then we started working at the local level as well. So there were more than a couple of seniors from school in Gwalior that I started working with, and they were helping me out. I was asking them for leads, they were asking for leads in return, all of those things. One problem that I faced was, now Gwalior particularly is a city which is very much near Delhi. So the resources that we were supposed to, like the resources which were supposed to come to Gwalior, before coming to Gwalior, they used to go back to, like they used to get like booked by people in Delhi. So there was a certain compartmentalization of resources in that particular manner, because people who could afford, they didn't really remain in Gwalior as well. So they went ahead to other cities for their treatment.
Well, thank you so much, Prerna, for your selfless service for saving our fellow countrymen.
For more such videos, subscribe to the NewsX YouTube channel, hit the bell icon.